everyone. Good afternoon. My research paper's topic is about how to make a satisfying website. And at first, the beginning, I write a paragraph about introduction. And I think it's very important because it can attract the audience eyes. And I did a lot of research about the history of the website. So we have three steps of the development about our website. The first generation of website is kind of a tool which people use just to convey the information and also to commute with each other. And we have at this kind of generation website don't have any visual things such as the bright color or brand picture. They're just the words in the screen. And the second generation of web design is like a platform to show your works and your information. And it includes a lot of visual things such as the bright color and icons and even some bright picture as a background. And it did a lot of progress based on the first generation. And from now we have third generation of the web design. And in this kind of step, we focus much more on user experience and much more interactive operations in web design. And also, a lot of companies may pay more attention about their user loyalties, and they convey much more information by different website link. So after we write a history of the website development, I start to write about my statement. So you can see on the bottom of the screen, I have my three statements. First is using the system font design principle, increase the content readability, and choosing the readable and accessible icons strengthen the identity of the web function. And the third is establishing the excellent user experience can bring the surprise to the viewers and improve the user loyalty. And I pay attention on the sentence parallel in my essay statement. So after that, I will talk about my three main points. So the first is using the system font design principle, increase the content readability. So how to make a satisfying website? The first point is about font, because the main element in the web design is the font. Because people spend a lot of time read information on the website, which is which is showing by the world. So the font readability is about the different space between each letters and the letters between the space between each lines, and of course the words accent and descent. In this paragraph, I cite the Jason Smith stations. He said, we don't just put a font or words in a screen, but we pay more attention about the font size and font colors and the font type. Of course, it can help readers to understanding the content much more easier. And then I write my own opinions, because I think the web design is a part of the graphic design, and it's also origin from the graphic design. As we know that font design is also based on should base on some principle rules about the graphic design, such as the composition of the whole website or the organizations of the each paragraphs by the by the designers. And I give an example in my articles, which is BBC News Online project. And the BBC user experience design team redesigned the BBC News Online. So they just use the Helvetica and the Arial font to restrict the variability in the content. and they also used only Giusan font in their banners district. So that means people can read their websites much more easier and concise. They don't be troubled with the crowd paragraphs and also the size and also the fonts size variation. So my next main point is choosing the readable and accessible icon strengthens the identity of the web function. And icons are a very important part of the web design because in recent days people will not spend so many times to read the black and white words. They, I think humans are willing to read pictures or some visual things rather than just the words. So icon can improve the efficiency about the understanding of the website, and it make people easier to get the information just by click the icons or read the some introductions about the icon. And also, I mean, icon is a very universal science in the world because it gives us a common perceptions about knowledge. For example, if we see a slant red line in a red circle, that means forbidden or prohibition. And if you see the magnifying glasses icon, that means the magnifying function. And if you see the pencils icon, that means the edible function. So if we don't tell these kind of meanings about this icon, you may understand the meaning of the icons. So that means it gives people much more convenient to operate the computer system or the web system. And also in the article Getting the Picture, the author also mentioned that the culture gaps and the conflicts between the icons and the meanings. And he thinks that designers and interface designers should consider about the culture gap between the different countries, because maybe Chinese think these icons have this kind of meanings, but American people think these icons may have this kind of meanings. So that's the things designers should consider about to improve the concise about the web design. And the third point is establishing the excellent user experience can bring the surprise to the viewers and improve the user loyalty. In article The New Imperative to Satisfy and Delight, the Joan Davison shows her opinions about the user experience. Sometimes it will give viewers a lot of surprise when they just go log into this kind of website. For example, if you log in this kind of website when during your birthday, so maybe the website may give you a birthday wish or some cozy animations that will make you feel much more comfortable when they use this website. And also, user experience is not only depend on the whole visual things of the website, but it's kind of the attitude of a company. For example, the Banner Energy is a company who made an automatic sensor in the whole world, and this is a manufacturing company, and it's located in all different worlds such as Asia, America, and South America, or even Europe. But most of their customers don't know their global business. So the designers try to put a global map in the first page of their website, so people can easily to see their business in different countries. And also they add some roller menus and of course some little animations in their web design. So after people use this kind of web, they may give their good feedback or positive feedback, and they will consider about to buy their products after they see their web designs. So that means good user experience is like a trigger to make the whole good events will happen after they use the website. So finally, I also find some limitations of web design, because sometimes if you want to catch the user's mind or make a very good impression about your product, you may not just show your product on your website or laptop. You may give them a postcard or a very delicate packaging about your products, and rather than just give them an email or a link on your website. So that means you may have another things to help the website to catch the consumer's mind. And finally, I have two challenges and one question about my research paper. The first challenge is about grammar, because I think I need to pay a lot of attention about my grammar, because it's totally different from the listening journal, because this is more I think this is more form and academic, so it's much more serious grammar. So, and also on the database I can find a lot of resources, but it's hard for me to decide which kind of resources is suit for my research paper. So reading is also a big task for me. And I have a question about my own research paper, which is adding a picture is necessary or not on my research paper. So I hope you can give me a good answer about my questions. Thank you very much.